Hi everyone, welcome back. In this video, you will learn how to use UI interactions to manipulate records by adding new rows, editing existing rows, and deleting rows in the Blazor Pivot Table. Also, I will show how to visualize the table data in a pivot chart and edit the data through the chart itself. I will open my existing Blazor application, where I have a Blazor Pivot Table component with a sales analysis data source bound to it. Here, I map the rows, columns, and values with the appropriate fields in the data source. If you want the step-by-step explanation of these code snippets and how to get started with the Blazor Pivot Table, refer to the video linked in the card above. When I run this application, you will see the pivot table rendered with the defined data. Now I will show you how to perform CRUD operations on the pivot table. To do them, I add the PivotViewCellEditSettings tag and define the properties allow adding, allow editing, and allow deleting to add, edit, and delete records in the pivot table. Look at here. When I double-click on any cell, the raw data of that cell appears in a new window. Here, in the toolbar, you can see the options to perform CRUD operations. First, I will show how to add a new record to the table. I click on the Add button and see a new row has been created here. I enter all the required fields in the newly created row and update the table by clicking the Update button. You can see the pivot table is updated with the newly added record. Next, I will show how to edit the data in an existing record. This row shows that 440 units were sold in Germany. To edit this cell, I will double-click it to open the edit window. Then, I will select the cell and click the Edit button. Now, the selected row is editable. In this example, I will increase the number of sold units by 10. After I update the changes, you can see that the sold units have increased to 450 in the table. Similarly, if I want to remove any row from the grid, I can select the row and click the Delete button. All right, we have learned how to add, edit, and delete records in the pivot table with the default normal editing mode. In addition to this, the pivot table supports three other editing modes such as dialogue, batch, and command column. Let me explain the different editing modes one by one. First, I'll use the dialogue mode by defining the mode property and setting its value to dialogue. I double-click any cell to open the editing window. When I select a row and click the Edit button, a dialogue pops up with the edit options. I can edit the values in the dialogue box and save the changes by clicking the Save button. Look at the table, the edited value is updated here. Now, I will show you how to use the batch edit mode. I change the value of the mode property to batch. In the editing window, I can edit multiple rows at once. And update the table content by saving the changes. Notice the pivot table updated with the edited values. Next, I will look at the last editing mode, command column. In this mode, an additional column with edit and delete icons is appended to the table. I can enable this editing mode by defining the property allow command columns and setting its value to true. I double-click on a cell to open the editing window. Here you see a new column appended to the table with edit and delete icons. I can edit and delete the row using these icons. I save the changes by clicking the Save button here. Next, I will show you how to display the table data using a chart. If you would like to display the table data in a graphical format for better data visualization, you can display it using the pivot chart. I define the pivot view display option tag. And within it, I define the view property and set the value as chart. I can also display both the table and the chart by using the both option here. For now, I choose to display the chart. Here you see, the pivot table data has been rendered as a pivot chart. I can customize this chart using the pivot chart settings options. In this example, I'll just add a title and change the chart type. The thorough explanation of the pivot chart and its customizations will be provided in our upcoming video. To add a title, I define the pivot chart settings tag and set the title property to sales analysis. To change the chart type, I use the pivot chart series definition and set the type property to column. As you can see, the component is now rendered with a column chart. Now, I will show how to perform CRUD operations through the chart. I double-click on any data point in the chart. See, the editing window opens, where I can add, edit, or delete the rows as shown earlier. Just like the pivot table, the pivot chart also supports all types of editing modes. Let me summarize what I have shown you. I showed you how to perform editing in the pivot table through different edit modes. Then I showed you how to display the pivot chart in the pivot table, how to customize it, and how to perform editing using the pivot chart. If you would like to see a working example of what we covered, you can download it from the GitHub link in the description below. I have also provided a link where you can see if you qualify for a free license key to use our Blazor products through our community license. If you found this video useful, please like the video and subscribe to our channel. Thanks for watching.